A Waimanalo woman known for having a big heart, welcoming foster children into her home, is dead tonight. Police believe she was murdered this morning, and they have a suspect in custody. Sarah Yoro has more on tonight's top story. Sarah.
Marissa, a family friend I spoke to identified the woman as Jolynn Kipapa of Waimanalo. For years, she and her husband Kirk have opened up their hearts and homes to children in need. A community is mourning the loss of a beloved mother, friend, and wife of a well-known entertainer. Friends of the family identified the victim as Jolynn Kipapa of Waimanalo. At about 8 o'clock this morning, Honolulu police were called to this home at Sherwood's Beach.
Upon arrival, they discovered a female victim with stab wounds. She was pronounced dead at the scene. And a male suspect was taken into custody at that time.
According to friends close to the Kipapas, that suspect is the family's 16-year-old foster child. For years, Jolynn and her husband Kirk have helped children in need. The family currently has 11 foster kids.
This is really tragic. I know it's, you know, the Kipapas' hearts, they're not going to stop, you know, taking in and always helping to shelter foster kids, yeah. This was their lifelong dream.
Andy Jamila has known the family for about 30 years. He says they love each of the foster children as their own. In fact, back in 2005, we spoke to Jolynn as she and Kirk opened up about their 10 foster children.
We have our trials and tribulations, but at the end, it's all worth it.
And back in 2001, Jolynn and Kirk had the privilege of performing during a retirement ceremony in Japan for sumo wrestler and dear friend Akebono. As for the investigation, there are still many unanswered questions.
Right now, it's a big minus right now, you know, having this happen, and, you know, we were all together just the other day over here. And this is something that was kind of surprising to us, too.
Police have opened a second-degree murder investigation. An autopsy will be performed to determine the exact cause of death. Sarah Yoro, KHON 2 News.